Good evening, everybody. Good evening. I didn't know. Can y'all hear out in the house okay? Okay, good. Well, so thank you so much for being with us tonight on the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee. My name is J.P. Miller, and I'm at the Ogle Furniture Outlet on Dolly Parton Parkway in Sevierville. For the next hour, we're going to have a live radio show here. We're also taping for television, so if you're here in the audience, make sure you suck in your stomach and look good. Don't fall asleep. But if you're out there listening on the radio, I believe it's raining. It sure was when I came in here. But if you're out there driving around, come on over. We're just getting things started off. We're located at 1063 Dolly Parton Parkway in Sevierville, the Ogle Furniture Outlet, big red building up on the hill. We're having a live radio show. It's a gospel music show. Every Monday night we have the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee, starting our fourth year. It's hard to believe, isn't it? But it has a live audience. When you come in, you can't miss us. I just kind of look to the right and you'll see about 50 folks or so laid out in recliners in the best seats in Sevierville. It's free. Tonight we have Stuart, Stallings from Eternal Vision. Stuart is an amazing bass singer. He's also a songwriter and he's also a comedian. So we have a lot of things in store for us. My pastor, Philip Morris, is here. We're going to be talking about an outreach that we are doing for veterans. A lot of our listeners out there are veterans, but we certainly do support our veterans. And we're going to talk about an outreach that we've got coming up at our church, Parkway Church of God, that we invite you to participate with us. We also have Pastor Dale Workman, who's here from Wedding Bell Chapel. Pastor Dale in Wedding Bell Chapel is a sponsor of our show, and as well as the Ogle Furniture Outlet and so many of our friends out there. We couldn't do the show without them. He's here. We're going to talk about things going on with the chapel, as well as he's going to sing and play for us. You know, he's a phenomenal singer and a musician. He bought his own keyboard today, he told us. So I think he said one of the Temptations or someone sold it to you. I can't remember who it was, but someone, you know, only in Pigeon Forge, you know, Elvis lives in our subdivision, and he mows his grass, and Elvis goes to our church, and then, you know, I was at Burger King one day, and the Temptations were there, so only in Pigeon Forge can you have all these dead famous people just running around town. You know, it's the place to live. If you're just tuning in, this is J.P. Miller and the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee, live coming to you from the Ogle Furniture Outlet on Dolly Parton Parkway in Sevierville. We invite you to come over and join us. It's a live show with a live audience. Come over and be a part tonight. We're giving away some great stuff. Right now we're going to hear from my pastor. He was here talking about the event that they've got coming up on Sunday, August 30th, Welcome Home Veterans. But Philip is a phenomenal singer, and he's coming with Pastor Dale to share a song. So would you make Pastor Philip Morris welcome?
Touched me, and all the joy that floods my soul. Something happened, and now I know He touched me and made me whole. I met this blessed Savior. Since He cleansed and made me whole, oh, I will never cease to praise Him. I'll shout it while eternity touched me. Oh, he touched me. He touched me. And all the joy that floods my soul.
Since 1938, Smith Madison Ogle Properties has been serving Sevierville, Pigeon Forge, and Gatlinburg with affordable residential and commercial rentals. We require no credit check or application fees. We believe in second chances. View our properties online or call 865-428-5161.
This is Chase Irwin, General Manager at White Pine Golf Club, inviting you to join us for a fun and casual golf experience. Whether you play 9 holes with a cart for $17 on weekdays or play all day any day for just $30, White Pine Golf Club is great for all ages and skill levels. Kids 12 and under play free, and senior rates are available Tuesday and Thursday. Come check out our fully stocked pro shop and newly renovated lounge areas. Don't forget, we are also your one-stop shop for club repair, alterations, and re-gripping. Call 865-674-9986 or visit our website at whitepinegolfclub.com and come see us soon.
Folks, the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee is full of surprises and full of fun. So if you'd like to experience a lot of stress, you should be a talk show host on the radio live. Don't you all think? You never know what'll happen, but you just... The show must go on. I know where they get that. I know where they get that. But Dale traveled with Jesse Dixon as his organ player, and you know he had to be good in order to do that. So I asked him just on a couple seconds ago if he would do a song for us while I get my stuff in order for the rest of the show. So would you make him welcome as he comes and plays for us, Pastor Dale Workman? Making him do it with no practice at all. And if we can find this cord around this man, we'll certainly be in good shape. Folks, if you are just tuning in, we're usually not this bad. It actually not too bad. If you weren't here, you wouldn't even know all this stuff was going on. Aren't you glad you're here, though, because you get to see what happens? My mom listens in West Virginia. She has since we started. You know, you can go on there, pay a fee, and be a listener on Praise 96.3, no matter where you are in the world, and you can listen online. So because, you know, I'm traveling, because my mom travels, she subscribes to that. So no matter where she is, she can hear the show. And she says, when she came here to visit us, and she was here in person, she said, I have much more respect for what you do, because you have no idea what happens on the show until you're there in person. Justin Terry was scheduled to be here tonight. Y'all know Justin. Justin's a bass singer, a young guy. He's been on the show before. He called me and he said, I am on my way to Europe. And I said, what? He said, I know I'm supposed to be on the show sometime. He said, but the Stamps called me. They need me to fill in for them on their tour through Europe. He's not married, didn't have any kids. And I said, go, buddy. How exciting. I'll figure out the show. So today I figured out, well, just now I'm figuring out the show as we're going along. But before the show, I said, hey, you think we could get together and the three of us work up a song or two? And we said, sure. But how exciting for Justin, you know, to be over there. What an opportunity. But, you know, the Stamps traveled with Elvis for years, and that's that they do Elvis a tribute and concerts over there. So Justin was supposed to be on the show, but he got a flight and went to Europe and is having a ball. I saw his pictures on Facebook. So when he gets back in the States, we'll get a call from him and see what's going on there. So yes, I'll tell them if he can't do it next time, we'll have Stuart do that. So don't worry, Stuart's next, bless his heart. So folks, one of the best hymns that folks always request, and no matter where we go, folks, do you know the old Rugged Cross? I said, we sure do. So we thought we'd sing that for you tonight.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the tears stand slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will all fear is gone.
that with us.
And because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future.
Folks, if you're just tuning in, this is the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee, and I'm the host, J.P. Miller, or I'm trying to at least, and if you are here in person, you've had a good laugh or two, but it's also been sweet. We've heard some great music, and that was one of them. I appreciate Marcy and Dale, and we just practiced right before the show, so I think they did a great job. I at least didn't screw it up too bad, I guess. Stuart, get on over here, sir. He's going to use this microphone, if that works. I don't know if it works or not. DJ, you want to put those on, buddy? I should have told him to walk up the steps earlier. Now he's going to be out of breath.
It's okay. You need good breath anyway.
How you doing, man?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm good. I saw where, so everybody knows, Stuart sings bass for Eternal Vision. He also does some comedy dates on his own solo stuff, but just lives locally and just down the road.
In Morristown.
In Morristown. Yes. So
we don't have no dead famous folks walking around there.
We don't have any dead famous
just
folks in
Morristown.
Just live
unknowns.
Live unknowns. Yeah. That's right. Eternal Vision has had quite a year or two.
Yeah, it's been a challenge.
Tell us what's going on.
Well, a lot of people I know that keep up with Eternal Vision, the group. Gail Shelby, one of the founders of the group, Mike and Gail founded the group back in 1989.
Mm-hmm.
And Gail has been suffering. That first she was diagnosed with, well, after a series of catching pneumonia and having trouble breathing, they went to the doctor, and she was diagnosed with trying to think what it's called, cystic fibrosis.
Yeah.
And they treated her for that for about a year, and then last year she was diagnosed, I believe it's called alpha 1 tryptophan deficiency.
Mm-hmm.
And what it is, there's an enzyme in the blood that or that's produced by the blood that it's a hereditary thing, and her blood is not producing that enzyme, and it causes either liver or lung damage, and it has damaged her lungs.
Mm-hmm.
So she hasn't been able to travel with us for almost a year and a half. Mm-hmm. Now, and we certainly covet the prayers of individuals that all over the country that are praying for her.
And so you all realize that the impact of this. Gail, Mike and Gail Shelby, the founders of the group, their son, Shannon, is the lead singer there. Gail is the alto singer. She also did the bookings for the group, so she was the one that called to secure the dates, to make sure things were happening. So she was not only a singer, she was one that handled the bookings and a lot of the office stuff, too.
Yeah,
did
most,
she pay
mo-
the bills?
Yeah, most of the stuff that, you know, that of that nature, she handled that.
So not only, so when you're looking at an employee in a business, okay, so you got to replace the singer or not have the singer, and then you also realize that the the founder, the other founder, has to continue on the road while she's at home or in the hospital. You know what I mean? So they, it's not like a normal job where folks have, you know, savings or sick time or anything like that. Yeah, anything at all like that. My dad worked for the FBI when he was sick, when he got off of his sick time. Folks could donate days, you know, if you ran out of sick days. When you're singing and when you're in the ministry and stuff like that, it doesn't work like that.
No, it doesn't. And that, you know, that's, of course, God provides, and we know that, but it's still a challenge.
Yeah.
And keep Mike and Gail in your prayers. Mike is especially taxed because he's had to pick up all of those other responsibilities. In addition to, he does all the maintenance on the bus, all of the equipment and so forth and so on. He's got all of those things to deal with. Plus, he's caring for Gail.
I know you typically sing with a quartet, but you're doing some solo stuff tonight. Tell me the first song you're going to do.
This is a song that I wrote. I was sitting there with my wife a moment ago, and I said, "How old is Stephanie now, my oldest daughter?" And she turned 29 in June. Wow. I didn't know she was that old. I don't know how she gets so much older and I stay so young.
Right.
But she's worked that out. But this song I wrote for her when she was 3 years old.
Yeah.
And, you know, this God literally, I've heard people say this all the time, JP, but God literally gave me this song. It's 2:00 in the morning. She used to wake up with night terrors.
Mm-hmm.
And if her mom went in there, she would scream that much louder.
Mm-hmm.
But Dad could go in, I could go in and turn her over on her side, give her a little kiss on the cheek, and she'd go right back to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Just something about Daddy being there to do it. And this particular morning, 2:00 in the morning on a Saturday morning, I went in there and I gave her a little kiss. She went back to sleep. And I walked into my bedroom, I sat down on the edge of the bed, and my guitar was leaning up against the wall, and God just started speaking to me. And I said, if I could have just a fraction of the faith in my Heavenly Father that little girl had in her earthly father, I could be a... You're talking about moving some mountains.
Yeah.
Boy, I could move some mountains. And just in about 15 minutes, God had given me the words to this song. I woke my wife up, and I said, "Honey," I said, "God has given me a song." And she said, "It's 2:00 in the morning. It better be a good day."
It'll be there in the morning. go make your way down, if you will, folks. This is the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee. J.P. Miller here having a great time with Stuart Stallings from Eternal Vision, talking about all the great things that they have endured and the great things they have in store as well that God has in store for them. But this is a song off his solo album that he wrote about his little girl many, many years ago. Make him welcome as he comes to sing for the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee.
She believes that I can do anything she asks me to. Faith in me is never compromised, and she's sure that I could answer any question she could ask. She never stops to wonder if I'm right, and she knows that if she cries, I'll be there to dry her eyes, hold her in my arms till it's all right. And if I could be just half a man my little girl thinks I am, I know everything will be all right. Help me, Holy Spirit, be the father I should be. Give me strength to lead my family closer, Lord, to Thee. Most of all, dear Father, I pray that You give me faith to trust in You, Lord. Where my little girl trusts in me, I tuck her into bed. After our goodnight prayers are said, she looks at me with eyes that see no wrong. Her little arms go round me tight. She hugs my neck with all her might. Drifts off to sweet dreams before long. For a while I watch her sleep, then I softly kiss her cheek. She won't be a little girl for long. Lord, help me be just half the man my little girl thinks I am. Help me, Lord, for her sake, to be strong.
Help me, Holy Spirit, be the father I should be. Give me strength to lead my family closer, Lord, to thee. Most of all, dear Father, I pray that you give me